They're calling it the biggest game in College Station in 20 years. A&M fans have been lining up since early this morning, and the atmosphere outside is as frenzied as it is inside and anywhere around the college basketball world. The only thing standing in A&M's way are the 7th-ranked Texas Longhorns, who are in College Station tonight. The Aggies and the Horns in a Lone Star State showdown next. Wednesday night basketball to the Big 12 Conference Reed Arena on the campus of Texas A&M University sold out for the first time this year. Why is that? Because their arch rivals, the Longhorns and the University of Texas, come calling. Horns are 24-4, Aggies 18-7, Texas ranked number 7 in the country. Here are the in the Big 12 Conference. Texas at 12-2, then Kansas, Oklahoma 11-4, and A&M and Colorado tied at 8-6. Hi, everybody. Ron Franklin along with Fran Fraschilla, and welcome to a jam-packed Reed Arena. This is a great atmosphere. Oklahoma, Oklahoma State, Florida, Florida State, Michigan, Michigan State got nothing on this rivalry right here, which goes back for decades and decades. And the thing for the Aggies tonight under Billy Gillespie, they truly think that they can play even Steven with Texas, even though they're number 7 in the country, Fran.
You're right, Rob. They're 5 wins in a row in the Big 12, first time in its history. This win tonight would be a signature, look good on a tournament resume. On the other hand, Rick Barnes brings in 5 starters who in Big 12 play all in double figures.
Take a look at the star watch. P.J. Tucker for the Texas Longhorns and Big Joseph Jones for the Texas Aggies.
Well, around these parts, many people think P.J. Tucker may be the year in the Big 12. And don't forget the sophomore Joseph Jones. 31 points last time these two teams met, including 23 in the second half.
So here are the starting lineups. First of all, for the visitors from Austin, Kenton Paulino, along with Daniel Gibson at the guards. And they'll start with 3 forwards, Tucker, Buckman, and LaMarcus Aldridge. And of course, at 7 feet, LaMarcus Aldridge really a sinner. A.C. Law, the 4th, Dominic Kirk, Chris Walker, Marlon Pompey, and Joseph Jones. Those are the 5 for the Aggies. And there are 7 players from the state of Texas in those 2 starting lineups. For Texas, they can clinch a share of the Big 12 title and a number 1 seed in the conference tournament with a win. Set a single second season record for the school with 25 wins. And for the Aggies, they can clinch that 4th spot at a first round bye if they win and Colorado loses tonight up at KU. Ball is in the air, and the ball will go to the Texas Longhorns to open on offense first.
Aggies play as aggressively half-court defense as anybody in the Big 12.
Tucker takes it along the baseline. The ball is blocked by Law, and it came right back to Tucker. Buckman, Paulino for 3, in and out. And it's going to be taken down by Dominic Kirk.
Texas will open in man, but you'll see a lot of 2-3 zone tonight.
Law works against Gibson, gets a screen out high. Law will pull up, shoot the jumper, in and out, unlucky, follow, nobody boxed out Pompey, and he scored the easy hoop.
Well, Marlon Pompey, a blue-collar guy, doesn't get a lot of opportunities. That was an easy one.
Bounce pass into Aldridge, and quickly they go to work on him. Buckman. Gibson. Plenty of time on the shot clock. Texas moving right into the student section. 18-footer, not there, LaMarcus Aldridge, and Pompey has just picked up his first foul. Billy Gillespie, the head coach at Texas A&M, second year as the head man here, the reigning Big 12 Coach of the Year.
He took over a team that was 0-16 2 years ago. Already has 16 wins in a little under 2 years in this league.
Pass comes out to Buckman.
Very active hands on the defensive end by the Aggies.
Texas wants desperately to get it into Aldridge and see if they can get Joseph Jones in foul trouble.
Very true, Ron, and the Aggies will try to double team in the post in that situation.
Screen out high, Gibson a long three, and he got it. That'll quiet the crowd for the moment.
Daniel Gibson has proven to be a prolific deep shooter this season. Aggies need someone else besides Law and Jones to score tonight.
Screen by Jones. Walker takes a long three. Not there. Pompey gets the long carry. Inside to Jones. Works against Buckman. Got it. Fist it off the glass.
Good solid defense by Buckman. Jones tried to draw the foul. Forced to hit a tough shot.
Buckman. Too hard. Walker rebounds A&M. Aldridge. Got a piece of it. Taken away by Gibson. 3-on-1. The numbers by Texas and P.J. Tucker score the hoop, and he'll go to the free throw line. A.C. Law will pick up his first foul.
Well, that started because of a weak pass by Pompey on the pick and roll. You see it's deflected, and here comes Gibson, and Law slides in as Tucker is in the air. It's a good call.
Good job by LaMarcus Aldridge. He was almost beaten but was dropping back on defense and got just enough of a hand on the ball. P.J. Tucker completes the three-point play, and it's a 6-4 Texas lead.
Keep your eye on this now, Ron. A little half-court pressure. Let's see how soon Texas goes back to that zone. Well.
Right now.
Right now.
Skip pass to Kirk. Along the baseline, they feed to Jones. Turned over by the Aggies. Gibson pushes it up. Buckman, the bouncer into Aldridge, and not there. The ball tipped away by Aldridge and taken down by Law of the Aggies.
Aggies going to make it very difficult for LaMarcus Aldridge to operate tonight physically.
Jones not there. Taken down by Pompey. Good job of hustle.
Third offensive rebound, and it's coming off LaMarcus Aldridge, something Rick Barnes will take note of.
Pompey almost slipped, which would have been a walk. Into Jones against Buckman. And Buckman's going to be called with a nickel dimer. Rick Barnes, the head coach of the Texas Longhorns, eighth season as the head man. 71, almost 72%. His winning percentage, 13-2 against the Aggies.
Incredibly, 65-4 versus teams in the state of Texas.
Probably one of his best coach games last year. Came over with a full contingent of players and got upset by A&M. Came back to Austin and played with both Tucker on the sideline along with Aldridge. As Kirk puts up a three, it's short. It put up an air ball, and as they battle for it, it's going to be taken down by Texas A&M. Law with a left-hander, three off the mark. So let's take a timeout. 15:38 left until halftime. Texas 6, Aggies 4.
Life in the NFL was tough on my body. I lived with muscle and joint soreness every day. Life after football can be just as tough. That's why for knee and elbow support, I choose Copper Fit.
CopperFit, advanced compression garments to help relieve muscle and joint soreness.
With my active lifestyle, my body reminds me it needs the support.
High-performance fabric to aid in faster recovery, performance, and guaranteed relief of muscle aches and pains, and blended with odor-reducing copper. Call 1-800-603-8135 or on the web at GetCopperFit.com. Get your elbow or knee for $19.99. Order now and you'll receive a second sleeve. Just pay separate shipping and handling.
For this old arm, I choose CopperFit. Go. Oh, come on. That was a perfect pass.
Feel the relieving power of compression. Feel the power of CopperFit. ESPN2's exclusive presentation of college basketball is brought to you by Volkswagen. On the road of life, there are passengers and there are drivers. And the new 99-cent Buffalo Snacker from KFC. Heat things up for under a buck.
And we are back, 6-4, Texas on top by a couple. And this young man is in the audience right now proposing to his girlfriend. This is not a setup. Well, I guess it was as far as he's concerned, but she's certainly shocked.
She gave him the thumbs up.
Yeah, Giga Maggie's.
Yep. Now let's beat the hell out of 2U.
You know, in rebounding in the early going, boy, the Aggies are off to a great start in rebounding. Texas in scoring margin, in rebound margin third, and in defense 37.6. But right now in the early rebounding, it is 8 for the Aggies and only 1 for Texas.
Well, the Aggies going to school on Oklahoma State's win 2 weeks ago. You must out-aggressive the aggressive team.
Walker with the three. To complete the point on Majors before timeout, Texas then came home and beat A&M without Aldridge and without Tucker.
Yep.
One of the better coaching jobs by Coach Rick Barnes last year.
See Chris Walker now only 6'4 guarding Buckland.
Lost it out of bounds.
A former walk-on senior night. Billy Gillespie calls him a powerless forward.
First turnover against the Longhorns tonight. Aggies up by 1.
Walker and Dominique Kirk both can hit the 3.
Going to be a travel. Marlon Pompey stumbling his way through traffic. 3 turnovers against the Aggies.
And Ron, all 3 by Marlon Pompey. Usually a good passer. He has over 40 assists on the season.
Mike Williams into the lineup for the Texas Longhorns.
See right there, Aggies trying to take the ball out of Paulino's hands on that possession.
DJ Tucker. Tucker, pull-up jumper, 8-footer, got it.
Very good shot over a contested hand by Tucker. These Aggies contest shots as well as anybody in the Big 12.
Walker. Going to be the second foul, I believe, on Pompey.
Watch PJ Tucker as he moves with the basketball. This is where he's so versatile. Now he moves without the ball, and then a tough shot over the outstretched arm of Pompey.
So Pompey goes to the bench at the 14:03 mark, and it means that Kavalauskas will check into the lineup.
Young man from Lithuania, Ron, has played very well lately. I asked Billy Gillespie why he's playing so well. He said, I'm playing him more. I was dumb early in the year, and he's earned some playing time.
A.J. Abrams, the freshman guard, into ball game number 5 for the Longhorns. He's out of Round Rock, Texas. Back out on the wing. He had 4 big 3-pointers against Kansas on Saturday and a double dribble called on Tucker.
Good, solid pressure defense so far. At the walkthrough, I don't think you could call it a walkthrough. We were at practice today. It was like a full-blown practice. All they did was work on the Texas offense.
Jones, he's off the mark there. Tucker rebounds. Tucker, another jumper. That one's going to be short. Barely drew iron. And I believe Mike Williams will be called for the foul or not. Or would it be the Aggies? Looks like Dominique Kirk will be called for the hold. By the way, congratulations to Mike Williams, second team All-Academic announced today in the Big 12 Conference. He, along with Connor Atchley, making the second team All-Academic Big 12. Williams out high with the screen. Gibson goes the other way. Nice bounce pass to Tucker. Tried to reverse it. And a 3-second call against the Longhorns.
One of the things that it looks like in the early going is Billy Gillespie is going to let Daniel Gibson handle the ball as much as possible in the half-court offense. So far, it has worked.
So Buckman comes in, and Aldridge, LaMarcus Aldridge, goes to the bench. Texas by one. Very low scoring game, but I would remind you that the final score in the Oklahoma State game here was 46-44. Mm-hmm. I thought we were back in the 50s playing there.
I think that's by design. Billy Gillespie wants to make it a grinded out affair. Texas can play that way as well.
Shot clock is at 4. Down to 3. Almost threw it away. Gibson hustles for it. And a shot clock violation, or over and back, actually. One tick was left on the clock, so over and back it would have been. And one more second, a shot clock violation.
Ron, I think what you're seeing in the early going is two of the better defensive teams in the Big 12. And they scout each other so well that nothing really comes easy and nothing is a surprise.
This is not a surprise right here. Martellus Bennett, who of course is on the football team, mm-hmm. at 6'7", 240, they have put him in the lineup. And Coach Gillespie said today during their shoot-around, we're going to need more big bodies because of the strength of Texas inside. That ball is blocked by Jones.
What a great reaction by Jones on the way up, and he got it on the glass.
Under 12 minutes to play. A total of 15 points have been scored by the two teams.
Around this zone has bottled up Joseph Jones so far.
On the floor, Abrams comes away with it, and he will take it. Wow, very hard foul by Bennett.
Very close to being an intentional foul. A good hard foul nevertheless. Going to make A.J. Abrams earn it at the line.
So there's a timeout. The ESPN family of networks salutes great basketball moments from each Division I school. ESPN News Prime in the program is on the way.
At this very moment on the campuses of Texas A&M, we are committed to creating new teaching methods to help children with autism find their voice. Coming up with new cures to fight cancer by treating it in man's best friend. And developing innovative smart grids to power the cities of tomorrow. So when called to take on the world's challenges, we don't hesitate. We step up.
Hey, Mom.
Yeah?
We've got Allstate, right?
Uh-huh.
Yes. Well, I found this new thing called
Allstate Quick Photo Claim.
It's an app. You understand that? Just take photos of the damage with your phone and upload them to Allstate.
Really?
So you get a
quicker estimate, quicker payment,
quicker back to normal.
I just did it. But maybe you can find an app that will help you explain this to your father.
Introducing Quick Photo Claim. Changing car insurance for good.
Why did you switch to Dish?
Everything was going okay with DirecTV,
but our bill was out of control, so we switched to Dish.
And we really do get the same great channels that we love to watch, like sports and news and kids channels, you name it.
And we saved $280.
$270.
$300, like holy...
savings.
Plus now we can watch all our live and recorded TV anywhere we go.
People are switching and saving. Switch to Dish and save $250 guaranteed. Save now. 1-800-CALL-DISH.
Texas up by 1-8-7, and it's time now for ESPNU's Pride of the Program. Tonight in the spotlight, Seton Hall. Led by Coach of the Year, P.J. Carlissimo, Seton Hall had gone further than ever. The Final Four. In the national semifinal, another first. The Pirates got their first win ever against Duke. And they advanced to the title game against the Michigan Wolverines. More Pride of the Program features available on mobile ESPN.
Here's some teams on the way up, on the way down. Obviously, Florida, Michigan State are in the tournament, not playing well. And then Seton Hall, big win last night against Cincinnati at home. They are very close to gaining one of those at-large bids if they don't win the Big East tournament.
For those just joining us, we are in Reed Arena on the campus of Texas A&M University. And it is a whiteout tonight as far as the student section. And a lot of the regular patrons as well have worn white. So we got a sea of white here at this arena. Abrams gets the first one. Aldridge will come back in, and Mike Williams will go to the bench.
How about this, Rod? Both teams have combined 6 of 19 so far.
Abrams got them both. I asked Rick Barnes today before his shoot-around, what makes Abrams so effective, and are you surprised? He said he's one of the toughest little guys I have ever coached, freshman, senior, whatever, and particularly a fella for his size. Kamenuskas back in the ballgame, number 44 for the Aggies. The bouncer inside to Jones. Aldridge protecting on the jump hook, and Jones didn't even touch iron.
Didn't even look at the rim when he released it.
Tucker back to Paulino. The bouncer inside to Aldridge. It is on the floor, taken away by Paulino. Kamenuskas will pick up the foul. And Paulino has been battling an ankle and also a knee. And Kamenuskas rolled up on it, and he hit the floor as if to say, let's don't go through this again.
Yep, take a peek at this, Ron. You're exactly right. Watch 44. Ooh. Looks like Paulino is shaking it off.
Abrams got the ball back to Buckman. Paulino into Tucker. 10 seconds on the shot clock, and he rolls it home. That's now 7 points for Tucker.
Well, that's what makes P.J. Tucker so dangerous. 6'5", 225, can score inside and out. How about his line on Saturday against Kansas? 19, 8 rebounds, 7 assists.
One thing is apparent. When they go low to Aldridge, he does not have time for a bunch of ad-lib moves because the Aggies are tripling him. Speaking of triples, the three-pointer is good. Walker again.
Well, a fitting way to go out. Young man has started every Big 12 game in 2 years after Billy Gillespie recruited him out of the intramural program.
Well, Paulino with a very lazy pass, and it cost him a turnover. And Jones doesn't realize the banks are closed.
That's it.
Tie ball game at 12.
Ron, you made the point about Aldridge. Very little orange in the lane so far.
It's going to be the 17th foul already on the Aggies.
Well, probably not how. First, Walker knocks down the long range three. That's the conventional way. And then Joseph Jones, not known for deep range, kisses it off the back of the glass.
Well, the front iron. Aldridge battling for it. Taken away by the Aggies. Kapiloskis. Law trying to get by Gibson. Too hard off the iron. Taken down. P.J. Tucker.
We've seen what Gibson can do defensively this year.
Gibson for three. Nope. Buckman tips the ball. Kapiloskis comes away with it.
Well, just what we expected. Two teams both understand what's at stake. A&M playing for an at-large bid.
Jones blocked by Aldridge.
Well, sort of a bailout move there. Jones turned with his right hand into LaMarcus. Wasn't going to get a good look at the basket.
First one on the way, and he got it. It's Throwdown Thursday tomorrow night at ESPN. Top 25s in action at 7 o'clock. Number 25, Wisconsin, takes on number 23, Michigan State. Game also available on ESPN HD. Jones gets them both.
Well, this game is at the Aggies' pace right now.
Aldridge, wow. First two of the night.
Ron, we saw that Saturday night, and we've seen practice this year. That was a sky hook, the Kareem Abdul-Jabbar way, something Rick Barnes has been trying to get him to use.
Yeah, how many times have we been to a Texas practice and heard, shoot it off the top, not lower, off the top. And he made 8 of 9 against KU this weekend. Ball is blocked by Aldridge. Kapiloskis kept it alive and scored.
I'm Texas. I continue to go inside.
It's going to be a three-shot foul against Law, his second. So let's take a timeout. A&M by a couple as we go to break. LaMarcus Aldridge with his first two.
Growing a business without a website is a challenge, but more than half of small business owners still don't have one. At GoDaddy, everybody who gets a domain name, website, and Microsoft email all for just $1 a month also gets their very own human to help you 24/7 for free.
What? I'm a bargain.
Having a website is critical to getting new customers. And GoDaddy has all the tools you'll need.
I'm a tool to help you get online.
Just call 888-765-8480 or go to godaddy.com/human to get your domain, website, and email. When you do, you'll get a free human to help get you online and be found by more customers. Customers who buy things. And it's all just $1 a month. Call 888-765-8480 or go to godaddy.com/human right now.
800-510-8306. Order now.
And we are back. College Station, Texas. The Aggies on top by a couple, leading the seventh-ranked Texas Longhorns. What have you seen so far, and what is Rick Barnes going to have to do to change it?
Well, I think they got to pound it inside. Here's a good example, Ron. LaMarcus Aldridge frees it right there. He's not a wide guy. When he shoots the sky hook, he's got to get his body between the ball and the defender, and that's why coaches love that move, because it's impossible to block. Particularly when you don't have that wide frame Buckman and Jones have. That shot just made him a lot of money.
Connor actually comes into the lineup, number 32 for the Texas Longhorns out of Clear Lake, Texas. And to repeat what I said earlier, he was not in the ballgame at the time. Connor was named second-team All-Conference Academics today as well, along with Mike Williams for the Longhorns, as Abrams misses the first one. And the Longhorns in a great position to with the Aggies picking up 8 quick fouls in the first half.
Well, that's a good point, Ron. The Aggies average 22 fouls a game, more than anybody in the league. You know, we talked about taking your aggressiveness to the opponent. If I'm Texas, I go right inside at that front line.
Third one on the way. It was a 3-shot foul, and he got 2 of the 3. Boy, Kansas, not surprised. They have jumped all over Colorado after losing soundly against the Longhorns this weekend. You would not expect anything less from Bill Self's team.
That's right.
Jones blocked, and a foul.
Well, good spin move. Joseph Jones recognizes the defender is on the top. Watch how he locates Aldridge, spins, gets away from him.
Second foul on Aldridge. Saturday night, ESPN, ESPN2, and ESPNU all ahead down to Tobacco Road to cover one of the best rivalries in sports. North Carolina takes on the Duke Blue Devils. College basketball Saturday primetime presented by Cisco Systems, available on ESPN HD.
Now we'll be down at Charleston, South Carolina, watching that one, Ron, as we get ready for the Southern Conference Finals on Sunday.
The SoCon.
Yep.
That'll be fun, and we head from there for the MidCon.
Exactly.
Out to Tulsa. Traveling America.
That's exactly right.
Aggies up by a couple.
See, I would go inside right now and continue to work that foul line. But in order to do that, you need a good angle from the wing.
Actually left alone, and he barely drew iron on that long one. Jones got that long, Carroll. First half. Reach in, Abrams.
Well, only the fourth team foul, so Texas in good shape.
Rick Barnes upset with the freshman, and he will never take up for the kid and jump on the official. He says, it's lazy, you didn't move your feet.
So because of that, we're going to go 2-3 zone.
Air ball. Kavaleskas on the follow, and he'll go to the line.
Both teams shooting a lot of three-point shots. I would go attack the basket.
That's on Tucker. And it's the first one on him. 5 team fouls, Longhorns.
Usually those Lithuanian guys can really shoot the ball. That one was wide left. No wind.
Nice
either.
Way of saying he didn't draw iron. He did on that one, hard off the back iron. So unfortunately for the Aggies, he misses both. So it's still a 2-point game. And I have a feeling that free throw line might be where this one's won tonight.
Oh yeah.
Tucker double steps through. No foul. Yes, a foul is called, and I think.
See, this is going to be a war of attrition tonight. So you want to put the onus on the defense by attacking them inside. Both teams play physical. You see now the step through and the foul by Jones.
First on him, ninth team foul. Tucker does a good job of stepping through on the double team because he is so strong, even though he's not a huge man.
Strong and agile.
Gets the first one. You know, the guy that we need to keep an eye on tonight and watch his numbers. Texas has lost 4 times this year. Twice, Buckman was injured and really could not help. The other two, he had not very good ball games. To me, the key, if Texas is going to win, Buckman's got to step up and have a good ball game.
Well, you're right. Like Kevin Book out at Oklahoma, these guys relish this kind
yes,
of game.
Exactly. Tie game at 18. Skip pass all the way across. Kirk picked up quickly, and Ashley with the steal.
That zone has done a good job of keeping the Aggies on the perimeter.
Carter prepares to check in. Too hard of the shot. Tip won't go. Kavaleskas over the back, no call. Ashley couldn't handle it, and Law at the other end is fouled, and he will go to the line.
Let me tell you what's amazing about that. A.C. Law is a left-hander, but he shoots the floater and the drive to the basket with his right hand. So keep your eye in transition. He gets to the basket, shifts hands, and then shoots that ball with his right hand, something he's very accustomed to doing.
Ashley will go to the bench. Mike Williams checks back in for the Longhorns. Love at it. Number 23, Josh Carter, freshman out of Dallas Lake Highlands, into the ball game. Number 23.
Unless it's wide open, I would put that three-point shot in my back pocket and work it inside.
Under 5.5 to play. Tucker deals to Williams. Now Abrams for three, and he got it.
And if he's open, you let him shoot it, because he shoots over 42%.
That's right. Freshman. At this juncture, he's no longer a freshman. Look at Jones, a long three-point attempt. Buckman grabs it.
Rick Barnes doesn't mind that long jump around, believe me.
Tucker, jump stop over Kavaleskas, wouldn't go. That's Gibson, and it's blocked by Kavaleskas. Buckman kicked it, and it goes out of bounds off Texas.
Well, that's okay. You got to like that if you're Rick Barnes. You want to attack the paint. Came up empty there, but good aggressive play. And Billy Gillespie is very happy with the flow of this game.
He should be. Mm-hmm. I mean, he's controlling it.
Yep.
Rick Barnes trying to get the officials to call some of the pounding inside. And they're not listening. Kavaleskas not there.
We joked with Rick Barnes today because A&M plays like a lot of his Providence and Clemson teams.
Exactly.
Before he had those McDonald's All-Americans.
Gibson with the wraparound pass. Tucker back to Abrams. Boy, he was open.
Yep,
passed it up.
Yep.
Williams for three. Count the basket. I think Buckman.
That would be number two. Williams shoots the ball. Ball goes in. They count the goal. Let's see if we can find Buckman right here. Watch these two guys go hand to hand right there. Ooh, nice shot. That ball's going to be thrown back. Now keep your eye on Buckman right here. Ooh.
He's slugging down. See the spin, and he got him with his left arm.
Yep. Buckman has two. Ron Aldridge has two. That last game against A&M, Aldridge had only 5 points in 20 minutes.
Too hard. Two Longhorns fight over it. And then a whistle and a foul. Is that going to be Jones? Boy, if it is, that Bennett, I beg your pardon. Tough one right there.
Well, here's how Buckman got that second foul right here. Watch him he just tries to get position.
Well, Walker is leaning on him. He's just trying to get him off, but you can't do it that way.
Right. As we said earlier, Gillespie calls Chris Walker his powerless forward. He's a small forward that's had a play inside.
Oh, my. Bennett with a second foul. Williams gets the first. It's Throwdown Thursday tomorrow night at ESPN. Number 25, Wisconsin against number 23, Michigan State. This game also available at ESPN HD. Throwdown Thursday presented by IBM. Williams with them both.
Hey, Rod, you've commented in the past about how good a scorer Williams was in high school.
Yeah.
And he's given Rick Barnes four quick ones today.
You know, I think what the lecture we always heard for him early was, we don't have you to score. I want you to screen and get rebounds. Kamenauskas way too hard in the shot, but Bennett with great hustle to get the rebound.
Well, Bennett looks like a tight end. It's because he is. Second team All-American. Coach Fran here at A&M.
Shot clock is now under five. Walker way outside. Barely drew iron and knocked out of bounds by Mike Williams of Texas. We'll be right back. Timeout, 3:24 left.
Whoa, 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 Marge. You're not Marge.
I'm sort of Marge. We both drive a stick. We both like saving money on car insurance. And we both feel integrity, such as that of healthcare in the America of the U.S. And therefore, yes. Thank you.
No, no, please, stop!
Sort of you isn't you. Start with a quote from Esurance and get a set of discounts personalized to you, not someone sort of like you. Esurance, backed by Allstate. Click or call.
If you're one of the millions who suffer from lower back pain, you need Be Active, the revolutionary new pressure system that quickly helps ease discomfort in your lower back, buttocks, and legs. Watch. Slip on Be Active and tighten the strap. You'll quickly begin experiencing relief. Look, back pain often radiates from the lower back to your lower extremities, but apply Be Active to the point of the lower calf muscle to quickly relieve pain. The secret is the pressure point pad that gently compresses, alleviating pain to the sciatic nerve and lower back for quick relief.
Be Active provides firm pressure behind the knee on a specific pressure point, which can help relieve the pain of suffering from sciatica.
Now, get Be Active for $19.99. Call now and double the offer free. Just pay separate processing and handling. If you don't like it, send it back and owe nothing. You get it all for $19.99. Call now.
To order, call 1-800-436-7159. That's 1-800-436-7159 or go online at beactivebrace.com. Call or click today.
Scott Reese, Hubert Davis in the studio. Coming up on the halftime report, we'll have the prognosis for Pops Mensa Bonsu's return to George Washington. A ton of scores and highlights, and Hubert, A&M up to the task so far.
Yeah, well, LaMarcus Aldridge has two fouls. He's on the bench. He's their guy that's dominant on both ends of the floor. Hey, Coach Fischilla, did you teach LaMarcus Aldridge that hook shot?
Fran, what's the deal? We'll see at halftime, guys.
Well, I'll tell you. It's not Coach Fran, but it's about four other coaches on the Texas staff.
That's it.
Every time you walk in that men's gym, that's what they're working on. He has had it pounded in his head.
That's a great point because he didn't really like to use it early in the year. It's pretty good.
But he's found out it is more than a lethal weapon. Interesting, in a really close ball game, 4 points. Texas only shooting 38%. Aggies done a really nice job against them, but only 31% for A&M.
Whoa, that was close. Joseph Jones looked back like he thought he tripped over that line.
Kirk over in the corner.
Ron, this zone is really bottled up, Jones.
Kamenauskas.
Well, the young man who came to America 3 years ago, he only knew three words. Maybe a fourth, three-point shot.
Paulino comes down. Billy Gillespie not happy about that because they were slow. They were lethargic in transition defense, and that left him open. And Kenton will take that shot every time. Oh, nice give, nice play, and he missed it. Carter missed the ball, and it gets tipped right back over to Paulino.
Carter still frail for a freshman. He'll fill out, but didn't finish because no body strength on that drive.
Can be a streaky shooter, can he?
Yes, he can.
Paulino, they leave him open. This time, too hard off the back iron, and Tucker picks up the foul, his second.
Well, Kamenauskas first with the finish, and then the backdoor cut, flashes to the elbow. There's the backdoor, and Carter, the freshman from Lake Highlands, just not strong enough to finish inside yet. Aaron Carter, who plays at Illinois. Now, you know what those three words were, Ron? Yes, no, and okay. That's all he knew when he came here.
That will help you get along with teachers, coaches.
That's right.
And the opposite sex.
The less said, the better.
Yes. Got the first one. Kavanauskas with 5 points. And rattles home the second one.
Well, the entire Texas starting front line on the bench now with two, so you just want to weather the storm the final 2 minutes.
Paulino, left hand, not there. Williams tried for it, and Joe Jones will take it away.
I think Rick Barnes would be very happy with a three-point lead right now with some key guys on the bench. Got to go inside if you're A&M.
Jones.
Got to take advantage of that inexperience in the game right now.
One-point ball game. Texas 28-27. 1:24 left until halftime. Abrams with the bounce pass. Actually can't run it down. Turnover Longhorn.
Well, it looked like it was going to be a great dish, but it went right by Mike Williams. Right now, if you're Billy Gillespie, that ball better get in Joseph Jones's hands or else.
And a timeout being called. So we're going to take the break with him. 1:17 until halftime. Texas by one.
Esurance was born online, which means fewer costs, which saves money. Their customer experience is virtually paperless, which saves paper, which saves money. They have smart online tools, so you only pay for what's right for you, which saves money. They settle claims quickly, which saves time, which saves money. They drive an all-hybrid claims fleet, which saves gas, which saves money. They were born online and built to save money, which means when they save, you save. Because that's how it should work in the modern world. Esurance, backed by Allstate. Click or call.
Attention parents and grandparents of young children. Gerber Life is accepting applications for their affordable grow-up plan. The grow-up plan gives your child $10,000 in whole life insurance protection now, then doubles automatically to $20,000 later at no extra cost. Free information will be sent to parents and grandparents who call now. Help give your child a head start for just pennies a day. Don't wait. Call now for free information.
Call 1-800-708-4137 or go to growupplan.com.
And we are back. Here's individual scoring in the ballgame. P.J. Tucker with 9 to lead all of the Longhorns. 7 for Abrams and 4 points for Mike Williams. Jones leads the way for the Aggies with 10. 6 points for Walker.
Well, you see right here, Ron, he gets Mike Williams on his back. You got to do your work early if you're Mike Williams. You can't let him establish that position. Right now, out of this timeout, I go into Joseph Jones, make sure he touches it.
Kavanauskas also with 6 points for the Aggies. Travel on law.
Well, they tried to set up a pick and roll where Jones rolled to the basket. Too long to develop.
So Law goes to the bench. Gillespie, a little bit of a grimace. He doesn't do that toward AC Law very much, though, because the young man does so much for him. And has come far. Gillespie thinks he can be even better.
That's
much
right.
Better.
Thank you.
7 seconds on the shot clock. Gibson, too hard. The tip by Williams wouldn't go. And Williams has it knocked out of his hands by Jones.
Well, Gibson did everything right except finish. And Mike Williams with an easy opportunity to put back. Good drive here by Gibson. And look how close Williams is. And just comes up empty. I know he's hitting his hand like he got fouled, but in a game like this, no rest for the weary.
Jones not there. Ashley has it. They double team him. He gets knocked down. And they got to give the ball to Texas.
Great piece of defense by Kenton Paulino that time. Great job by Paulino. Jones had the easy roll to the rim, and Paulino from help side. Watch this, Ron. Well, we got the end of it here. But a terrific job by the senior from Los Angeles to really stop a layup right there.
1.5 seconds left until halftime. Kavalauskas must have blood. They sent him to the sideline. Yeah, looks as though he's wiping his chin off. And that means that number two, Bennett, will come back into the lineup for the Aggies.
Remember that last game in Austin where Chris Walker got that gash over his left eye?
It came from Bennett.
Yeah,
11
that's right.
Stitches. You remember
yep.
that?
Still got a nice little mark there.
They're going to take him onto the locker room. They may have to do stitches on him.
Chris Walker, a tough kid. You can't see it right there, but that left eye, Ron alluded to, 11 stitches, just starting to heal. Former walk-on, Grapevine, Texas native.
Already graduated.
Yep.
Graduated with what? Well over a 3 point, I think 3.8 in computer science. Abrams gets the shot away. It's going to be short. And we are at halftime. With our score, Texas 28 and Texas A&M 27. Now let's hit it to Scott Reese with the halftime report. Scott?
All right, Ron, so a good ball game at Reed Arena in College Station. A&M possibly playing to improve its at-large stock and make itself a viable candidate for a bid to the Field of 65 should the Aggies' Hubert Davis not win the Big 12 tournament. Why have they been so successful so far?
Well, they have the starting front line for Texas is in foul trouble. They both have two fouls, so they've been on the bench. That is Texas' strength in terms of defensively blocking shots and on offensive end, creating high percentage points.
And, of course, Aldridge on the bench with 2 points and two fouls, certainly not helping the cause. Now, I say that A&M might be one of those bubble teams out of the Big 12. Speculation is conference is going to get four, A&M or Colorado, probably not both. So what about the Buffaloes playing in Lawrence, Kansas? And this not for the faint of hearts. This has been one-sided, to say the least. How about it behind the back from Julian Wright to Brandon Rush? Mario Chalmers will knock down the open three to make it 15-3. And Hubert, I think KU a little frustrated after that loss to Texas, taking it out on the Buffs.
A little frustrated, but this is not going to help Colorado. They needed a stronger showing here in the first half.
Colorado was 1-for-21 from the floor until just a few minutes ago. They hit a couple of shots to make it look slightly better, but going to halftime, they're going to be down by 20. Your Big 12 standings, and again, the top four will get byes in the first round, so A&M would clinch that first round by in the conference with a win over Texas combined with a Colorado loss to Kansas. Other college basketball, Mensa Bonsu of George Washington had arthroscopic knee surgery yesterday to remove a small portion of cartilage. Dr. James Andrews performed the surgery, says he expects Pops to rehab quickly and be ready to play in the NCAA tournament, and surely the Colonials need their big man in the middle to do some damage in March. A lot of scores and highlights to come. A ridiculous number of top 25 teams in action simultaneously, including Duke putting that number one on the line against Florida State. And Bruce Pearl, well, he's drier today. That's the good news. The bad news is you may have to adjust your
chair. Oh!
The orange is out.
Oh!
Tennessee.
ESPN2's exclusive presentation of college basketball is brought to you by Dodge. You can take life as it comes, or you can grab life by the horns. Dodge.
Hey, Mom.
Yeah?
We've got Allstate, right?
Uh-huh.
Yes. Well, I found this new thing called...
Allstate Quick Photo Claim.
It's an app. You understand that? Just take photos of the damage with your phone and upload them to Allstate.
Really?
So you get a
quicker estimate, quicker payment,
quicker back to normal.
I just did it. But maybe you can find an app that will help you explain this to your father.
Introducing Quick Photo Claim. Just another way Allstate is changing car insurance for good.
All of your favorite ESPN networks, including the SEC Network and SEC Network Plus. The SEC Network is 24/7 coverage of the Southeastern Conference, including live events and studio shows. SEC Network Plus includes over 1,000 live SEC sporting events, only available digitally through Watch ESPN. Watch anytime, anywhere on your smartphone, tablet, computer, or TV. Download the app or visit WatchESPN.com.
You may have heard J.J. Redick is the all-time leading scorer in ACC history.
Who?
J.J. Redick. And, Carolina coming up this weekend, but not before the Seminoles get their shot at number one, and Al Thornton making the most of it. Redick for three. He's got 25. Hubert just 9 of 24 from the field, though.
Yeah, he's struggling from the field, but he's really working hard to get his shot, starting to get it there in the second half.
Meanwhile, nobody told Florida State they were supposed to roll over here. Todd Galloway, nice look to Alexander Johnson. Three-point lead for Florida State at the half. Second half, J.J. again working hard, but Duke getting all it can handle down in Tallahassee. Johnson will pull up from 17, and the friendly roll in the home gym. Three-point game over on ESPN, ticking down toward 4 minutes to play. Number two, UConn heading into South Florida to take on DeBolts. First half action, Marcus Williams, Denham Brown, who's really come on for the Huskies.
Yeah, the bench players have been huge for Connecticut. Brown, Adrian Anderson. Brown tonight, 13 points off the bench.
It was UConn by 13 at the half. Marcus Williams to Josh Boone, and it looked like this was going to be a laugher, but, well, nobody laughing when it was suddenly a five-point game. Jason Holmes for three, and it was at one point just five with about six to play, but down the stretch, well, UConn, oh, look at that, it's only a three-point game, but eventually UConn just asserting its presence down low.
Yeah, they have the a dominant post player, Josh Boone, Hilton Armstrong, get high percentage points in the paint.
Number four, Villanova and Jay Wright taking on St. John's. First half, Lamont Hamilton crashing the boards. That's fundamental. Johnny's up by a deuce. Randy Foy from the wing, and when these guys are shooting it well, impossible.
Yeah, he's picking up with the injury of Allen Ray, still the best backcourt in college basketball.
And there is Foy again. Next possession, would you believe? Sure you would. You've seen it all year. Foy one more time.
Someone guard him.
He scored 14 straight points for Villanova. They're up 13 right now, 12 to go in regulation. Other Big East scores. Louisville just trying to get into the Big East tournament. Leads Marquette 58-55, 17 seconds to go. We'll let you know how that turns out. And Notre Dame, gee, another close game for Notre Dame. How do you think that's gonna turn out?
It's going to go right down to the end.
Somehow
and Notre Dame's going to lose.
Point or two. Exactly. Kentucky and Tennessee, Jawan Smith from the corner. Checkmate. Vols take a four-point lead. Then Jordan Howell. See, it's not just Watson and Lofton and Wingate, the complementary players.
Well, the way Kentucky's playing defense, they're allowing Tennessee to shoot 71% from the field. So
okay, there's that.
Anybody can score.
And the offense not so efficient either. Throwing the ball away, Major Wingate throws it down, and that's a good-looking coat on Bruce Brown. Well, the NFL situation is getting dicey. We'll have the latest on the labor talks and tell you which big names have already been given their pink slips.
Hi, Phil Swift here. This is Flex Shot.
the easy way to caulk, bond, and seal. Simply push the trigger to make quick repairs with pinpoint accuracy. FlexShot fills huge cracks and holes, making everything completely waterproof. And it's mildew resistant, perfect for kitchens and baths. FlexShot is a super strong adhesive that lasts up to 30 years. Water gushes out of this huge hole. But after it's sealed with FlexShot, there's absolutely no leaks. That's amazing. You can get FlexShot for just $19.99. Plus, we'll include this extension tube. But wait, we're going to double your order. That's two cans of FlexShot and send you a free handy can of FlexSeal. The easy way to stop leaks fast. You get it all for just $19.99. Order now.
To order, call 1-800-510-8306 or go to GetFlexShot.com. That's 1-800-510-8306. Order now.
What will be known as the best day in SEC Network history? The day that Texas A&M took over. I'm Casey Smith, SEC Network reporter and Texas A&M former student. And I'm here to tell Aggies everywhere, it's all Aggies, all day. The 12-man takeover is happening, and I'll be your host. And get ready to watch the best that Texas A&M has to offer.
Marquette, Louisville, final seconds, Cardinals by three. And Marquette looking for a little bit of magic, and they get it from their young point guard, Dominic James, at the buzzer, and that's the way it's gone for the Cardinals. So we've got overtime, and if Louisville does not win this game, they might find themselves needing a win at Connecticut on Saturday to get into the Big East tournament.
They should win this one.
That's the way to go, at home. Today's Duke North Carolina moment, February 5th, 2004. Chris Duhon's reverse layup with 6.5 seconds left in overtime gives Duke its 16th straight victory, fifth in the last 6 years on North Carolina's home court.
So, I don't want to see this.
Yep, there it is.
Who put this on?
Rashad McCants drilled the three-pointer in overtime to tie it and set the stage for Duhon's heroics. But in the end, the Dukies get the win on the road. And, of course, you can see the next chapter for yourself on three different networks. College Basketball Saturday, primetime, Carolina at Duke. And, of course, ESPN2 will have the Above the Rim cam and the Fan cam. Cameron Crazy's over on the U. The game is on ESPN Eastern on Saturday. Well, as they continue to try to work out their labor issues in the NFL, here are some notable cuts on Wednesday. The Bills, Panthers, and Broncos were busy. Mike Anderson, the outstanding running back, on the chopping block. Likewise for Steven Davis, whose career could be over with Carolina. AJ Cause, as the Longhorns look to the perimeter, he had 7 points in the first half. Horns by one over A&M.
Security used to mean long-term contracts, but with SimpliSafe, you get total security without a contract. Now you can feel secure and free. Most alarms rely on vulnerable landlines, but SimpliSafe is cellular for a stronger, more secure connection, so you can trust that your family's protected by emergency services 24/7.
I'm away from home, but my girls are safe, and that's huge in my book.
There's no contract, and I get peace of mind. It's a great system.
Now you can protect your home for less than half what traditional companies charge. SimpliSafe, it's the smart choice for home security. See for yourself why SimpliSafe is getting so many rave reviews. Order your system today to get free shipping and a 3-year warranty. Plus, a keychain remote worth $25 absolutely free. Act right now and get 10% off your order as a special bonus. Go to choosesimplisafe.com today.
Welcome to SimpliSafe. Alarm on.
ESPN2's exclusive presentation of college basketball is brought to you by Toyota. Choose any direction as long as it's forward. Toyota, moving forward. And McDonald's.
And we are back. It's a one-point ball game. Texas on top. When A&M played Kansas here, A&M had the issue forced on them by KU in the second half, and the Aggies were not comfortable with that. Do you think the Longhorns might try the same thing?
They need to. They need to get some easy baskets in the open court, but I think, Ron, there was not much strategy talk at halftime. It was more about who's going to be mentally tougher, particularly in the paint in the second half.
Well, two ball clubs that are extremely tough when it comes to playing defense and going after one another. But one thing Texas has to be careful of is inside. Aldridge, two fouls. Tucker, two fouls. Buckman, two fouls.
And for that reason, they open up in that 2-3 zone, try to protect that front line.
Aldridge tips the ball away. They were trying to go for Jones.
Well, this zone has really bottled up Joseph Jones pretty nicely. He does have 10 points, but he's had to earn them.
We had that big game up at Austin. That ball knocked away by Tucker, and it's a turnover. Paulino out on the wing. Almost stolen, and it is. Great hustle by Dominique Kirk. And back to Pompey. Scores, and he's fouled by Buckman.
Well, that's his third, which is probably more important than the 2 points. But it came off of a turnover, the open court back and forth pass, and a great finish. See, nobody has inbounds plays against the zone anymore. So they throw it out top, that ball's poked loose, and then it's stolen right back right here. And this leads to the pretty two-on-one. Buckman picks up number three.
Joseph Jones picks up a foul. His second.
Ron, one of the things we've seen this year to start the second half, we talk about the coaches making adjustments in the locker room. The officials do as well. One thing they do pretty well is make sure they keep it called closely early.
They left Buckman in the ballgame. It's Paulino that he took to the bench because of the lazy pass and the turnover. Aggies by one.
Well, Texas A&M traps that pick and roll. It's always dangerous.
Tucker.
Speaking of dangerous, 12 feet and in, pretty deadly. Texas needs to answer that trap.
Texas back on top by one. Tucker now with 11. He's 50%, 4 of 8 from the field. Perfect from the free throw line. Way outside. Kirk not there. Tipped by Gibson. And the Longhorns come out running. Tucker on the wing. Law fouled him. He's going to say turnover.
Well, he drove the baseline. Tried to get a shoulder by A.C. Law. And right there, he steps on the line.
Law fakes the shot. Skip pass here to Walker.
Now anything that keeps Joseph Jones away from the basket is good.
Shot clock is at 7. Down to 6. Down to 5. Law way outside. Tucker grabs the rebound.
We mentioned that Ron Jones is not getting a lot of touches versus that big front line in the zone.
On Gibson.
They don't have an offense for that trap. That should be a 4-on-3 situation.
Law. Jones walked, got away with it. Ball is an air ball. Tucker had it stolen.
Got to try to get the ball inside versus that zone. They do have some set plays they can run.
Hey, Aggies very deliberate. Coach Gillespie wanting to keep this probably in the 50s. Walker, ball blocked by Buckman. 5 seconds on the shot clock.
Well, we've seen this 2-3 zone not be just a change-up defense for Rick Barnes, but a weapon. And it has done the job in terms of bottling up the inside game.
Gibson, who is battling tendonitis in his right knee, goes limping off the floor. Rick Barnes going to get him some rest. 3 seconds, down to two. Law put up an air ball, and it'll be shot clock violation, and Texas will toss it in.
Solid defense right there, that whole possession, and primarily because Joseph Jones has not got a lot of touches. Texas needs to go inside. They're spending too much time on the perimeter.
Shot clock is down to 10. Tucker by Kavadoskis. Lost the ball out of bounds, but he was fouled, I believe, by Kavadoskis.
Well, and this is a team against Kansas on Saturday night, that front line at 49 points, 25 rebounds. So primarily because of foul trouble and good defense, they've been bottled up tonight.
Buckman only 0-for-1, no points. Kirk goes to the bench and checking in number 23, Josh Carter. Paulino, they set the screen for him and he swishes the three.
Excellent execution. They gave him a little bit of space. And the senior, playing with great confidence, knocks it down.
Texas by four. Jones, the lob, taken away by Tucker. Tucker, the distance, can't get it. The tip by Aldridge and taken down by Jones.
Well, as long as Joseph Jones operates in the high post, that's good for Texas.
Three-pointer by Carter, and I mentioned he can be streaky, so you better keep close.
Yes, he can. 35%, freshman, a lot of moxie.
Buckman for three. Nope. Not even sure he drew iron on that one.
Now, Texas spending too much time on the perimeter right now.
Law. Walker for three. Jones knocks it out of bounds. Texas basketball. So let's take a timeout. 15:03 left in our ball game. And Carter with the three to make it a 1-point ball game.
Kutch.
Oh, 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 a pirate's life for me. A pirate's life of a happy life.
Sunday Night Baseball, presented by Taco Bell. Cardinals, Pirates, and eight. Baseball rules on ESPN.
All of your favorite ESPN networks, including the SEC Network and SEC Network Plus. The SEC Network is 24/7 coverage of the Southeastern Conference, including live events and studio shows. SEC Network Plus includes over 1,000 live SEC sporting events, only available digitally through Watch ESPN. Watch anytime, anywhere on your smartphone, tablet, computer, or TV. Download the app or visit WatchESPN.com.
Scott Reese in the studio, and looky here, sports fans. Florida State up 4 on Duke in the final seconds. J.J. Redick can't hit. Scramble for the ball. The Noles recover. They're going to the free throw line with 1.7. The game is pretty much over. The Noles will win, but it's going to take a while. They're going to have to clear the court because the fans rush the court with 1.7 left. Meanwhile, Louisville takes care of business and beats Marquette by 7. Wow, guys.
Well, anytime you knock off the team called the Blue Devils, I guess it is worthy of a celebration, because in recent years they just haven't lost very much.
That's,
have they,
right,
Fred?
That's a good win for Florida State. Now keep your eye on this inbounds play, Ron. It's amazing when you execute an inbounds play well, how much confidence the player has, because he knows the shot is for him. Paulino takes his man away, and then he comes back off the double screen, and look at this space right now. Freeze it. Look at that space right there. That's called separation, and in rhythm, knocks the shot down. Excellent execution.
...15 minutes left in our ball game. What's at stake? If Texas wins, they assure themselves of the number one seed in the Big 12 Conference Tournament in Dallas. Carter, not there, and Aldridge rebounds it.
Well, not bad strategy. They put Carter, who just made a three, on the same side as Joseph Jones to try to loosen that zone up.
Now, what's at stake for the Aggies? If they win, and Colorado was getting pounded the last time we heard from Lawrence, that would be... You see 34-23. That would be a lot for the Aggies to draw by in the first round of the Big 12 tournament. Shot clock is down to 8. Tucker along the line tried to reverse it, and steps are called.
Well, it took a while, but I like the idea of Rick Barnes coming out of that timeout looking to get the ball inside. I think that's how you have to go right now.
12 turnovers against Texas.
See, they try to isolate Jones on that block with the shooter.
Law looks up at the clock, 10 seconds on the shooter. Down to 8, down to 7. Walker will take the 3. Not there. Battle for it. Aldridge comes away with it for the Longhorns. And Abrams all the way. Taken away by Walker of A&M.
Good job by Texas getting back, so that A&M now has to attack 5 players. And they need to go back and get Carter and Jones on the same side.
Kavanauskas with not a good shot. And on the baseline, Walker takes that away from Paulino. Under 13 minutes to play. Texas tries to set up a play as the shot clock hits 10. Abrams again had a three-pointer, passed it up, misses the 2, and Walker rebounds. One and out for the Horns.
That's a very good point, Ron, because at 5'10", you don't want to get caught in too deep when you've passed up an open shot from the arc.
Buckman prepares to check back in, and we were watching Gibson as he sat down on the floor after checking in. He really is exercising that knee. I think the tendonitis is really beginning to bother him. Jones, that's a travel. He got Aldridge in the air, and it's LaMarcus who's taking the deep breath right now, because if he had moved forward without walking, it surely would have been a foul on Aldridge.
Well, it's a real situation. Anytime you have Jones at the high post, you don't want him operating down low. You almost want him shooting over LaMarcus Aldridge with that long wingspan.
Dominique Kirk is coming back into the ball game. Field goals made, Texas 10, A&M 11. Turnovers, 13 to Horns, 10 A&M. And I spoke in terms of wanting the game in the 50s. Heck, we're going to be lucky if it gets into the 40s.
Oh, this is like a football game where you're just waiting for that one turnover. A lot of three and outs today.
Paulino pulling up, not there. Aldridge tips it, has it knocked away.
Yeah, that was just a hustle rebound by A&M.
Walker for three. Gibson calls a timeout.
Well, more great hustle plays. That's the way this game has gone tonight.
So let's take a timeout. 11:37 left. Longhorns by one.
Esurance was born online, which means fewer costs, which saves money. Their customer experience is virtually paperless, which saves paper, which saves money. They have smart online tools, so you only pay for what's right for you, which saves money. They settle claims quickly, which saves time, which saves money. They drive an all-hybrid claims fleet, which saves gas, which saves money. They were born online and built to save money, which means when they save, you save. Because that's how it should work in the modern world. Esurance, backed by Allstate. Click or call.
North Carolina like never before with ESPNU Full Circle. ESPN will have the traditional game coverage, while ESPN2 will show the game from above the rim cameras. And ESPNU takes you into the stands with the Cameron Crazies. Enhanced stats on ESPN 360, game alerts and live updates with ESPN Mobile. ESPN Full Circle, complete coverage everywhere, Saturday at 9. So we are back, Reed Arena on the campus of Texas A&M University. Ron Franklin along with Fran Fraschilla. And great to have you along. It's really a defensive struggle. 35% for Texas in the ballgame, 35.7. The Aggies now at 28.9. One number that you pointed out to me during the timeout as you look at that record number, 13-176 in Reed Arena. 3 of 16 for the Aggies from beyond. That's too many three attempts.
Way too many. The reason teams play zone is to keep it out of the inside because you can't shoot it. When you shoot too many threes, you play right into the defense's hands.
Aldridge puts it on the floor, gets the shot away, and I think it's going to be foul number three on Jones.
Well, and for Texas, you must go at the interior of Texas A&M.
So we'll take a timeout. 11:23 left. Texas 33-32.
What will be known as the best day in SEC Network history? The day that Texas A&M took over. I'm Casey Smith, SEC Network reporter and Texas A&M former student. And I'm here to tell Aggies everywhere, it's all Aggies, all day. The 12-man takeover is happening and I'll be your host. And get ready to watch the best that Texas A&M has to offer.
This is the face of a rock star.
A 50-year-old failed rock star. Yeah! Oh.
Long story short, I have a daughter. She showed up in New York,
and she's the new lead singer of my band.
Is that her? I'm in. I'm way in.
You are going to be bigger than ever.
Maybe Mom was wrong about you.
What did she say?
You're a lazy, selfish, pothead alcoholic with a death wish. Thank you, Daddy.
Sex and Drugs and Rock and Roll. Series premiere Thursday at 10 on FX.
Yeah, that's my dad. One day you're gonna have those tags.
Welcome aboard, Captain.
Everyone has a reason to live a healthier, longer life. What's yours?
Click today.
Texas by one in quite a low-scoring affair, but the biggest thing that happened on that last play, look at A&M, 9-3 in games decided by five or less. They won the last six. The biggest thing that happened on the last play, though, Joseph Jones picked up foul number three. Obviously, cannot afford to do without him.
And if you're Rick Barnes, Ron, conversely, you go inside and you pound it inside against Jones.
And that's what you've been recommending for a goodly part of the second half.
But I'm not coaching, and I don't get a win or a loss, so it won't matter.
Aldridge misses the first.
Long as Outback is open after the game.
That's where you're going, huh?
No, not really.
Aldridge only 2 points on the evening. He's 1 of 3 from the floor, 0 of 1 at the line, and now makes it 1 of 2.
Now, if you're Texas A&M, you must have a zone offense that gets the ball inside. Otherwise, you're going to be forced to shoot jumpers all night.
Jones blocked by Buckman. Paulino fights for it and loses it back out of bounds.
Well, that's okay. Good job now of getting it inside. Buckman comes up with a good play. You see, the play is for Jones to seal Buckman, and Buckman goes pretty much straight up and gets all ball.
In fact, he didn't leave his feet
That's
to make
right.
sure he didn't foul.
Now, you can't be discouraged if you're A&M. See, they don't have an inbounds play. It's amazing to me how many teams in college basketball don't attack the zone from the baseline.
On the inbounds pass.
Absolutely. We saw it the other night on the steal at midcourt, the Oklahoma State game.
Boyd Law, and they're going to call the foul on Paulino.
You see right here on the drive, Paulino just a little late. He's got to get both feet in front. Don't have to necessarily be established, but he's got to get his torso in front of the ball.
A&M has not scored for the last 5 minutes and 35 seconds.
Well, this is why that zone defense has been so effective for Texas this season.
Law. Nope. Buckman grabs the rebound.
Now if you're Texas, go inside.
In other words, go right back against against the big fella. Shot clock right now is at 10. Bouncer to Aldridge. Reverses the jump. Not there. Tip back out. Kovalevskis tips it to the Longhorns.
See, Ron, all season long, P.J. Tucker has been the guy they should go to in the post, but he's at the small forward spot now. We've seen Buckman and Aldridge be great backside offensive rebounders when they go to Tucker.
Gibson way outside, not there. Buckman skies for the rebound, and A&M fights for it, and they have a travel as two Aggies trying to hustle for the ball, and a walk is called on Dominique Kirk.
Well, good hustle right here. Sometimes you just can't help this when your team is playing hard. Two guys chase it down, they run into each other, and I've said before, that's an era of commission, something a coach can live with. Same inbounds play.
Paulino.
Well, if you can't throw it into your big men, second best thing is dribble penetration.
You know, he never really impresses you with his speed, but with his quickness, like there, the quick first step.
Very sneaky.
Three-pointer, Dominique Kirk. Check it. Carter, Josh Carter with a second three-pointer. 23 instead of 22.
Well, remember, Paulino hit the jump shot off the first inbounds play we showed you a little while ago, so now Law plays up on him, gets into the lane, as you said, Ron, very sneaky. And then Josh Carter coming back, second three tonight. Rely on that three all night. You still have to go inside.
A reminder, it's Throwdown Thursday tomorrow night on ESPN. 7 o'clock Eastern, number 25, Wisconsin takes on the... Michigan State. Game is also available on ESPN HD. Throwdown Thursday, presented by IBM.
Well, both of those teams need that win to gain some momentum going into the conference. Both in a little bit of a free fall.
Foster, 2 3-pointers in the ballgame. So the Aggies are now 4 of 7 from beyond the line. Carter, the hottest shooting of all of them, 2 of 3, 66% for him.
Well, you mentioned that streaking. It's not unexpected from a freshman.
Gibson. Buckman left alone, and then Kapodiskus comes out on him. Aldridge comes out with a high screen, and Gibson back over to Buckman.
Best thing for A&M is anytime there's a ball screen, because Texas has not handled it well.
8 seconds of the shot clock, 7 seconds. Gibson slips into Tucker, tries to reverse it, and I think Joseph Jones just picked up his fourth.
Well, intelligently, Kapodiskus raises his hand.
It's going to be his third.
Good, smart move. Good teammate, Ron. It's a good teammate right there. Takes the foul, and sure, he did foul him, but he raised that hand right away to make sure the officials did not give it to Jones.
Tucker misses, does not have a point, I don't believe, in the second half. Still stuck on 11.
Anything with P.J. Tucker going to the basket is good. I'm not sure there, but
no,
it's like 2 fouls.
I start to see.
Yeah.
Jones, I thought, did commit the foul.
Well, that makes it an even better play then for Kapodiskus. Rather him pick up the foul than Jones. Double foul. We got a double foul, Ted Hillary tells us, so the ball goes the alternating possession.
So 8 minutes, 39 seconds left in the ballgame. Texas by 1.
See, the guy that should be posting up is Tucker.
Well, that's what they get. Goes down on the floor after the ball. And tie ball, and on the possession area, it'll go to the Aggies.
Tell you what, Ron, Chris Walker is one of the few guys we've seen this season that does a great job of holding his ground against Tucker. Watch him move his feet. The ball is poked loose first by A.C. Vaughn. Good help defense.
About to go into 8 minutes left in the ballgame. Carter passes up the 3, goes back to Law. Sudden kind of a hush over the crowd. 9 seconds on the shot clock. They'll start to count it off. We're under 8 on the game clock. Kapodiskus will take the shot. He gets the 2. And A&M goes back on top by 1.
Young man from Lithuania has really stepped up for Billy Gillespie in the second part of this season.
Paulino. Nope. Carter skies for the rebound. Carter for 3.
Fool's gold. Can't keep shooting that 3.
Paulino. Gibson left alone. Got the 3. And look at the grimace on his face. The right knee is the one that he's suffering from tendonitis with. And I know that Coach Barnes, if they were not playing such a tough and important game here tonight with Oklahoma coming up this weekend, he probably would have him on the bench a goodly part of the night.
Well, and this is the danger for Texas, because they're not a deep team, and an injury or foul trouble in the NCAA tournament could really be a hindrance to a team that's ranked 7th in the country.
Well, Kapodiskus, we've talked about what he's done tonight. Here's a 2-pointer, and it gives him 8 points on the evening to go along with 6 rebounds. He has had a very, very steady ball game.
Now, on the other hand, Ron, I get back to the quick shot by Carter, and then the made 3 down here turned into really a 5-point play. And four of 18 from behind the arc. You got to find ways to get the ball inside to Joseph Jones.
Well, this is what is at stake. Texas can clinch a share of the Big 12 title and the number one seed in the conference tournament. Also set a record for 25 wins. A&M, if Colorado loses tonight, which they have been losing up in Lawrence, they would clinch the fourth seed and a first round bye in the tournament. That is with a victory over Texas here in this ball game.
I also think, Ron, with a win tonight would give them a signature win. 19-7, 9-6 in the league, 6 in a row. You want a team that's hot down the stretch. This would look very nice on the tournament resume of Texas A&M.
Well, here is the old arena, G. Raleigh White Coliseum. And the nickname for this, when I did games back in the Southwest Conference, they called it the Holler House on the Brazos. And I'm telling you, it not only was loud, but because there was so much steel in the structure, this man right here, Shelby Metcalf, the longtime head coach of the Aggies, really would ignite the crowd and get his Aggie team going. And I'm telling you, it was the Holler House on the Brazos. It was really something that opposing teams hated to come in here and have to face. Shelby, by the way, great guy. Not only a really good basketball coach, great bass fisherman.
Great sense of humor as well.
Yeah.
Well, you get an example right here back in 87, Ron. This was a team that was eighth in the Southwest Conference tournament. Big upset winner, and they went and played Duke in the first round and was knocked out. Of course, you'll recognize a young Mike Krzyzewski in a minute. Duke sends the Aggies packing.
Tell the generation by the short shorts, and those were real short shorts. The Aggies all greatly appreciate this man. Oh, he's had some issues with his health lately, and we wish him the very best. He's a longtime friend, and I hope that Shelby is here many, many, many more years to see the Aggies play in person at Reed Arena.
Man to man, Ron, first time since early in the game, Texas has gone man.
See what kind of set play they come up with out of the timeout. It's going to be a whistle and a foul on the floor. Mark Whitehead with the call. Second foul on Daniel Gibson. And now checking team fouls, both teams have really taken care of business. Only 14 fouls Aggies, 3 against Texas.
I think a lot of that is because of how closely the beginning of the second half was called by this crew.
Under 7 minutes to go.
Back to the zone, which they use underneath on the inbounds. As long as number 30 is at that foul line, that's a good thing for Rick Barnes.
He had 31 the last time they played. May have gotten away with a little stutter step there, and he cans the jumper.
Had to hit a tough shot.
Tie ball game at 39.
You'd have asked Billy Gillespie if he would honor to be in this situation today, he would have grabbed it.
Paulino. Ball goes over to Texas A&M.
Good solid defense, one of the best in the Big 12. Good ball pressure. You see the convergence on the drive. And then Paulino knocks it loose. Just a simple 1-3-1 offense. See, they had Jones rolling down the lane and they didn't look at him.
Law. Not there. The tip up wouldn't go, and it's taken away by Gibson. Gibson with the crossover takes it to the hoop, and he was fouled on the floor before the shot. Second foul on Walker. Fifth team foul, and as we said, not a shooting foul. They Kabaleskas just hit Buckman with a forearm in the mouth.
Well, these guys have gone after each other all night. Just watch Kabaleskas right here. Nice hand-to-hand combat. Kabaleskas has not learned what Buckman and Kevin Bookout do so well, and that is smile at the officials.
Gibson, not there. Buckman scrambles for the rebound and knocked out of bounds by Texas. A&M ball. So with 5:18 left to play. Now, the Aggies with Kabaleskas picking up that last one, that gives them 16 fouls. So the bonus on the next foul by Texas. But not many advantages for either team when you come to look for little cracks.
That's right.
Like that one.
There has not been much that you can rely on tonight.
Carter. In and out, unlucky on the shot, and it'll go back to Buckman. The youngster had been 2 out of 3, and that one did everything but go down.
That's sort of what I mean by fool's gold. You can't just rely on shooting threes.
A&M 4 of 19 from beyond the arc. The bouncer to Tucker, not there. The tip won't go. And I think Buckman just picked up the foul. He did.
Now, P.J. Tucker, this is the most room he had tonight to score. Look, he's got the angle to the basket. Walker flops a little bit, Tucker misses it, and then the over the back. Look how much room P.J. Tucker has. In close.
And kind of hard to believe it that Walker did not pick up a foul. Mm-hmm.
I think in this kind of game, it's going to be no autopsy, no foul down the stretch.
I think you're right. Buckman with 4 fouls goes to the bench. Under 4.5 minutes to play. Jones. The runner got it. 2-point lead, Aggies.
That would be a pretty good place to go since he got 31 on this team last time out.
Ball is tipped, stolen by A&M's Walker. And Law at the other end scores it.
Ron, they struggled with pick and roll offense all night. Every time they run the play, it's double team. And the Aggies have quick hands.
Tucker. Fifth foul on Kabaleskas. He'll go to the bench. Aggies with a 4-point lead. We'll be right back.
This guy, it's gone. Andrew McCutchen rides one out.
Rule 22, beware the pirate known as Kutch.
Oh, 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 pirate's life of a man. A pirate's life of a happy life.
Sunday Night Baseball, presented by Taco Bell. Cardinals Pirates at 8. Baseball rules on ESPN.
ESPN networks, including the SEC Network and SEC Network Plus. The SEC Network is 24/7 coverage of the Southeastern Conference, including live events and studio shows. SEC Network Plus includes over 1,000 live SEC sporting events, only available digitally through Watch ESPN. Watch anytime, anywhere on your smartphone, tablet, computer, or TV. Download the app or visit WatchESPN.com.
Scott Reese in the studio. Northwestern may not be in the field of 65, but the Cats trying to affect the brackets, beating Wisconsin last week. And here, up one late on Ohio State, but Ron Lewis bails out the Buckeyes with the layup. And now with 0.9 left on the clock, it is Ohio State up by one over Northwestern. Elsewhere, Florida State upsets number one Duke 79-74. Big day for Al Thornton with 26 points and 6 rebounds. And we are counting down to the second game of our doubleheader. The big Aussie, Luke Neville, leading Utah as we tip off against TCU approximately 10:05 Eastern.
So we are back 43-39, Texas A&M leading by four. It's their largest lead of the night. Joseph Jones, 14 points, helping lead this 11-3 run for the Aggies.
Well, and he's had to do it the hard way tonight. Nothing's come easy against this big front line. He's knocked down a jumper. Gets a little bit inside, and his first time in the second half that he's able to post up versus that back line of the zone. The Aggies by four.
So the foul situations, Aggies already giving Texas a bonus. Texas has only 14 fouls, so they've got a couple to give before A&M will go to the line, but right now it's going to be Law. Kavadoska's on the bench, fouled out. As we said, he had a steady night. 6 rebounds, 8 points.
And what he does is take one weapon away against that zone.
The miss, big.
In a few front ends of one and ones they've missed here.
Three and a half minutes to play.
Now Pompey is really no threat at the high post.
Shot clock at 6. Bouncer into the corner. Law with 1 second on the shot clock got it away, and Gibson will come down with it for Texas.
Joseph Jones did not touch that ball one time in that entire possession for Texas.
P.J. Tucker to Aldridge. That's a travel.
Well, Tucker got doubled very quickly. Aldridge would have been better off just shooting that foul line jumper. This is exactly the pace Billy Gillespie would have drawn up. Realizes he doesn't have a lot of offense.
And a timeout called by Texas A&M. 17 turnovers against the Longhorns. Saturday night, ESPN, ESPN2, and ESPNU all ahead down Tobacco Road to cover one of the best rivalries in sports, North Carolina and Duke. College basketball Saturday primetime presented by Cisco Systems, available on ESPN HD. Call your cable operator or satellite provider.
And we talked about Billy Gillespie and wanting a game plan that kept his score low, Ron. This is right up his alley. He knows he can't beat Texas in a shootout, so he's turned this game into a grinded-out affair. And Texas is really helped by playing the zone because it has slowed down the pace even more.
2 minutes and 40 seconds showing on the clock. And Texas has got to come out of their scoring drought as far as field goals. They only have 12 on the night. 12 of 35.
It's like man to man. So how do you get the ball inside to Joseph Jones? See, Carter's got him and he goes away from him.
4 seconds on the shot clock, stolen by Tucker. And Tucker against Pompey will miss the shot. Buckman comes away. Paulino for three. Carter with the rebound.
Josh Carter made a heads-up play because he got rid of the ball before he fell to the floor. Well, it started with the steal by Tucker, who could not convert. See, Carter needs to look inside. He doesn't do it. Tucker gets loose. Buckman gets the rebound. And then all night long, the Aggies have been Johnny on the spot. Great hustle.
Kirk comes back into the ballgame. Dominique Kirk and number 23, Josh Carter, will go to the bench. Carter's given him some good minutes.
He has. He really has, Ron. He's a little reluctant to throw it inside, but he's only a freshman, doesn't want to make a mistake.
Long. Jones travel.
Well, that's their bread and butter play. They try to get Jones loose on the wing, but he shuffled his feet.
A minute and 50 seconds left.
4-point lead in this game is like a 10-point lead. Texas must score. Good play.
Aldridge left all alone. And Coach Gillespie sitting there shaking his head like, what in the heck happened?
Every one of the eight assistant coaches got up and looked at each other.
Oh, my goodness. Still a 2-point lead by the Aggies, though, 43-41.
There he is.
Pompey, the double quickly by Paulino. Walker, not there, Buckman rebound.
Good challenge by Aldridge.
Walker picks up the foul. Third one on him. And that's the eighth team foul on Texas A&M.
Now Buckman goes at about 77%. Texas A&M on the other end must find ways to get. They need about two more baskets.
Buckman converts the first. That is his first point of the night. It comes at 1:06 left in the ballgame. And as we said, of the four games they've lost, two he could not participate in, and the other two he did not have big nights. In all the big games, he has come up huge. So he gets two here to make it a tie game at 43-all.
And what I really believe is at stake for Texas A&M in this final minute is an at-large bid. They need a signature win. Good job on the perimeter defense.
Inside to Jones, works it up too hard, taken down by Texas. There is about 5 seconds difference between shot clock and game clock. Would you call a timeout or would you do what they're doing?
It all depends, Ron. I would normally not call a timeout so the defense can't change. But A&M doesn't usually play zone. Let's see what Rick Barnes does.
Shot clock is at 10, and now he calls a timeout. With the shot clock at 10, at 15.6 on the game clock. So we'll be right back. Tied at 43. We got 15 seconds left in this one.
Hey, Mom.
Yeah?
We've got Allstate, right?
Uh-huh.
Yes. Well, I found this new thing called
Allstate Quick Photo Claim.
It's an app. You understand that? Just take photos of the damage with your phone and upload them to Allstate.
Really?
So you get a
quicker estimate, quicker payment,
quicker back to normal.
I just did it. But maybe you can find an app that will help you explain this to your father.
Introducing Quick Photo Claim. Just another way Allstate is changing car insurance for good.
What will be known as the best day in SEC Network history? The day that Texas A&M took over. I'm Casey Smith, SEC Network reporter and Texas A&M former student. And I'm here to tell Aggies everywhere, it's all Aggies, all day. The 12-man takeover is happening and I'll be your host. And get ready to watch the best that Texas A&M has to offer.
So we are back. Here's the reset. 43-all. Five fouls against Texas, still one to give, and that is big.
That's right.
A&M with eight, two timeouts each. But the point being, if the Longhorns score or not, they got a foul to give, and we're at 15.6 seconds.
Right. They have 10 seconds now to get a shot. So A&M, if they secure the rebound, will get it back. Now the question is, who do you go to? Tucker would be the guy I go to because of his versatility.
Tucker way out front. 6 seconds. Down to five.
He's got to go.
Down to four.
He doesn't
down
realize it's a shot clock.
I don't think he does it. 1 second of the shot clock, and it's a shot clock violation. How can you not know, Tucker? How can you not know?
Well,
that is absolutely inexcusable, and Rick Barnes knows it.
Now, remember, Ron, you're right. They have a foul to give. P.J. Tucker was looking at the game clock and not the shot clock.
So we'll be right back. So we're going to hold it right here.
Well, once he didn't attack the rim when it got under five on the shot clock, you knew he didn't realize the situation. He's dribbling around. The horn goes off.
The only thing I can think of is just what you said, that he was looking at the game clock and not the shot clock. But I just, with a man of his experience, I can't understand it. I really cannot understand
it. No, he's not really a guard, even though he handles the ball so well. And I said in that, coming out of that break, Ron, I would like him to have the ball because he's so versatile. He can beat you off the dribble and he's powerful. But he obviously didn't think like a guard in that situation.
So what do you do? 2 or 3 seconds into the play, if you're Texas,
right,
do you use that one more foul that you have?
I think you should. You've got to give it probably before midcourt, because once the ball comes over midcourt, if the ball handler senses that you're trying to foul, he may be smart enough to throw a shot at the rim. Now, we know, we've seen this all year, that 6 seconds, 5.9, means you have at least six dribbles if you're the A&M player. You can get the length of the floor in four dribbles, which means you also have time to pass off. A.C. Hall will probably have the ball in his hands. Now, if you're Rick Barnes, you must determine where and if you give the foul.
And I wonder how many people in this arena realize that Texas does have the one foul to give. Walker's going to pull the trigger. The man closest to him is number 22, Dominique Kirk. But it's going to go to Long. Down to four. Down to three. There's the foul right there. 3.6 seconds left. Now they got to put a play in motion that they only have 3.6.
But there's two things here. Either he drew up another play, or he can call timeout. He chooses to call the timeout.
30 seconds. Timeout, Texas A&M.
Ron, against Oklahoma State in the 46-44 win, they ran a pick and roll, and that got Jones free. They probably don't have the time to do that now. So you can throw the ball directly into the post, or you can get it to A.C. Law with time to create off the dribble.
A&M's last points, 3:57 left to play. Made it 43-39. And since that time, Texas has come back to tie it up at 43.
Well, what amazes me about the Big 12 this year is how many games have come down to the final play. People talk about it being a down league. It's a young league, good players. Take a look at this. You know, you look at Oklahoma and Kansas State, A&M, so many close games. And I really believe an at-large bid is on the line for A&M.
Walker to pull the trigger. 3.6 seconds left. Long. Way outside for the three.
It's good.
He got it.
It's good.
game winner. 3.6 seconds left. Walker with the inbounds pass. And watch AC Law take the pass. Puts it on the floor twice. A third time, crossover dribble, and way out beyond the arc, and he hits it just before the clock went out. Aggies win. And with Colorado losing, they're guaranteed the fourth spot in the Big 12 Conference Tournament, a bye in the first round. One more look with the clock. You'll see just how close this was. Got it away. Left his hand with one full second left on there, and it goes down for the win. AC Law with about a 23-and-a-half footer. So the final score, A&M 46, Texas 43. Next up, Utah TCU. For Fran Frischel and our entire crew, Ron Franklin saying so long. Let's go to Fort Worth and Dave.